Today, we'll start with Chapter 1, Computer Languages. These are the topics we'll cover in this chapter, that is the introduction to the programming language, the types of languages, machine language, assembly language, high-level language, compiler and interpreter. First of all, we should know what is language and what is computer language. Language, I think you all are aware, it is a medium of communication through which we can communicate with each other. We can exchange our ideas, information, and feelings. It can be in the way of writing, reading, or speaking. Now, what will be the computer language? The language which is used by the computer, that is known as computer language. As you all know, computer is a machine and it understands only binary language. Binary language means in the form of 0 and 1s only. So to communicate with the computer, we need some languages. These are called computer languages. There are different generations of computer languages. There are five generations. When the computer came into the world, that was the first generation language called 1GL. It is also known as low-level language. The second generation language, or 2GL, also low-level language, is known as assembly language. They are sometimes used in kernels and hardware drives, but more commonly used for video editing and video games. The third generation language, or 3GL, are high-level languages such as C, C++, Java, JavaScript, and Visual Basic. The fourth generation languages, or 4GL, are languages that consist of statements similar to statements in a human language. That means, in a 4GL, the languages are more easy to learn and understand as they are similar to our common English language. The examples are Perl, PHP, Python, Ruby, and SQL. The fifth generation languages, or 5GL, are the programming languages that contain visual tools to help develop a program. Examples of fifth generation language include Mercury, OPS5, and Prolog. Let us understand the classification of the computer languages. There are basically two types of languages. The one is low-level language, the other one is high-level languages. Under low-level language, two types of languages are there. The first one is machine language, the second is assembly language. But in the high-level languages, the third generation, fourth generation, and fifth generation languages come. The third, fourth, and fifth generation languages are all high-level languages which are very easy to understand and easy to learn. Let us discuss about each one by one. First is machine language. The computer is a machine. As you all know, it understands only 0 and 1. Machine languages is the only language that is directly understood by the computer. It is expressed in binary form, that is 0 and 1. It is also called binary language or low-level language. Machine language means the computer, whatever input we give to the computer, that is in the form of English. But the computer does not understand that English language. It converts that English language into binary form and then generates the information which is gives you the output. For example, the number 9, which we all know mathematically, is equivalent to 1001 in binary. Whatever you study in maths, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, that is all the decimal numbers. But in binary, they have only on the 10 code in the form of 1 and 0 or the combination of 0 and 1s. So we need a binary translator to verify it. The second low level language is assembly language. Assembly language uses mnemonic codes or symbols in place of ones and zeros. After some time, when machine language was there, assembly language came. So assembly language in the place of ones and zeros was using mnemonic codes, which were similar to some English words, which helps in the better understanding of the codes. So mnemonic codes are English codes used to represent memory location where data is stored. Computer cannot understand assembly language directly. It need to be converted into binary language. As we earlier discussed, the computer understand only the machine language. So assembly language is not understood by the computer. So it need to be converted into binary language. So the translator program called assembler is used to convert assembly language into machine language. Now what is a translator? For example, we go to a different country. There we don't know their language. We know English or Hindi, but the Spanish language we don't know. So we need a mediator which can translate our English language into Spanish and their Spanish language into English. So that mediator once is called translator. So same way, when we are writing a program in any other language rather than machine language, that all programs need to be converted into binary form by any translator program. We'll learn about translator programs later. Let us discuss the another one, high level language. High level language. High level language is English based language. High level language is a pure English based language. A user can easily understand and write its code. The translator programs called compiler or interpreter converts a high language program into machine language. So high level language uses English and mathematical symbols like plus, minus, divide, modulus, etc. for their program construction. They are problem oriented languages, for example C, C++, Java, etc. There is an example of high level language program. So this program returns the greatest number of two numbers. As you can see, there are some English words which the computer doesn't understand. So we need to convert it first with compiler or interpreter translator program. Then the computer can generate output of it this program. The four generation language, these are the language that consist of statements that are similar to statements in the human language. It uses a graphic user interface. It focusing on the dropping and dragging elements and generating code. Instead of writing, there are some visual tools that we can drop and drag directly to the code that will be easier for a programmer. It focuses on creation of the reports, websites and databases. The examples are Perl, Python, Ruby, SQL. So all these generation languages are used in computer so that we can write and read a program or get the work done by the computer. The about the translator programs will go through the next video. Till wait, practice this and understand. Thank you.